Alright, back again, Luke here, and today what I thought I'd do is show you guys some of the arcade boards that I have here. I've had a couple of requests on this, as well as many other requests as far as my other game systems and other games go, but for right now, these are a couple of the boxes that I have easily accessible, so I figured I'd show you some of the arcade boards and some different sizes and some of the different games that I have. Now I have about two other boxes here, and these are some pretty big boxes, but I got two more of these that I need to dig out, and I'll make another video of those when I get a chance here, but these are two that are accessible, so figured we could take a look at what's inside here, and yeah, let you see what I got. I got some of my manual stuff here. Yeah, here's the here's a manual for my Ridge Racer cab that I was finally able to get. That is just massive. Not super interesting, but let's see here what we can dig out of the old box. Now, the first board that I have here, this is actually Double Dragon 3. A lot of people really disliked this one, and it was not super popular just because the graphics on the game itself looks totally different from the original and Double Dragon 2, but it's a quite small board compared to some of the other Double Dragon ones. It's only a single board. It doesn't have two parts to it. It doesn't have any of the straps on it either, but one of the interesting parts of my collection here. And let's see if we can get this out of the way here. The other ones that you've seen in previous videos, this one's all taped up, but yeah, I can't really get to this one. This one is my double check this. And this is my Mortal Kombat 2 board. This is the sound board on top here, and then on the bottom, this is the main board. No, this may be not a very good video here. This is one that I got from El Cheapo Uno, or at least these are the instructions for it, and this is Contra. If you remember that trade that we did a long, long time ago, these are instructions for Contra. I have that board laying in here somewhere. I'll have to dig that out. this is Mortal Kombat 1. And as you can see, it's got the cable here that runs from the main board to the sound board. And, you know, it's a quite, you know, large PCB, considering some of the other boards are a little bit smaller. This one's a little bit bigger. But that one works pretty well. Let's see what else we got here. These are my instructions for... What's this one? This one, I believe, is for my Double Dragon 3. And this is for Mr. Driller 2. Put that laying around here. Captain Commando. These are the instructions for that. And these are the inserts for Captain Commando. Yay! Captain Commando. I don't know if you guys will enjoy this video, but I was watching a lot of the videos, and there's a lot of stuff going on with the E3 stuff, so I figured I'd put up something a little bit different, you know, probably a little bit more boring, not so exciting. This board here, I'm not sure what this one is. This one is RuneArc, if you can read that or not. What's interesting about RuneArc is I actually have two copies of this game, but I only have one and a half copies, if that makes any sense. This is the main ROM board, and on the bottom I have the motherboard, and I have the ROM board. I have another ROM board for RuneArc, but I don't have another bottom board, so I wound up picking this one up here because I didn't have the extra bottom board for it, so I could never play it. But yeah, RuneArc's a pretty good game. It's a slightly smaller board here, but I'll take that one out. And there's the instructions for RuneArc. Look at that. It's got that kind of old, really old look to it. And one of these. That's another instruction manual for RuneArc. Here's my instruction manual for Ninja Gaiden. If you remember, I put up a video of that a while ago. There's a nice huge chunk eaten out of it. More of the inserts here for RuneArc. And this board, it says Ninja guide in on it, but I'm not sure if this really is ninja guide in or not. No, this is not ninja guide in. What board is this? This one's Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. I can't get it out of the wrap here, but this is Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. It's another single board. One of the main reasons why I could tell here is by the sound volume pot. It's quite old, but Turtles. And this is the two-player Turtles board here. Next up here, this is my other rune arc, as you can see here. I don't know if I can turn this one around, but you should be able to read that. As I drop my camera, no. Yeah, this one here says rune arc on it. But this is the other top board that I have for it. Hopefully that sound is not too muffled. And I got quite a bit of stuff down here. So remember these? These were really popular back in the day for mods. I still got three of these left. These are for the original Wii, the first run that they made. These are the Wii keys. Got three of those. what else do we got in here? Let's see. Other boards we can dig out. This one is... This one is my, Mr. Driller 2. Okay, it's a little Namco mark on it. Mr. Driller 2, pretty good game. I don't know if I made a video of Mr. Driller 2. I probably didn't. There's a few boards that I've never ever made a video of, but I have to get around to doing that sometime soon. Other paperwork down here. Three Wonders. Choco Vader. I remember this one. This one was a really kind of fun and wild one, Contactee. Pretty interesting board. This one's for... Oh, that's for the Contactee as well. As well as this stuff. There's too much laying around here. Here's my Insector X that I showed. I made a video of that. That's my arcade manual, and there's my Seal of Authenticity right there. And as we get down towards the bottom, there's a neo-geo MVS BIOS. Got all sorts of stuff laying in here. It's been so long since I opened some of these boxes up. I really need to get around to doing that more often. This board here is the... Well, this is Magic Sword. I don't know if you can read that or not. It's probably not going to be the clearest, but Magic Sword here is another great game. Capcom game. Let's see what else. This one here. This is Gusun Oyoyo, which I haven't put up yet, but it's a really, really great puzzle game. Really fantastic. Kind of like a Solomon's Key type game. But another great game. Let me know if these are too boring for you guys. I just thought I'd, toss up something there. Had a few requests to see some of my arcade games and stuff, so decided to put up this video. Jeez, I don't know. Half of this out here. So, this one is... I think this one's my Emerald Paradise one. This is one that's that I showed with the Blast City. This one came with the Blast City. It's kind of like a Tetris game. Or Emeraldia. I can't remember the exact name for that. This one is not Mr. Driller. This one is... What is this one? I think this is Mr. Driller 1. I think I have Mr. Driller 1 and 2. I think I have both of them. Yeah. So, one of the two. And what is this monster here? After not using some of these games for a very long time, it's kind of difficult to remember which game is which. This one. What is this one? This is a really big board. can I not remember what this is? I have no clue what this is. Looks like a... Yeah. Jeez. I don't know. Oh, this one's the goosing oil. Okay, good. I'm starting to get worried. Like, finding boards in here that I don't even know. Hey, I got some extra boards. I just don't remember what they are. In here, this is, got some more Runark manual stuff, instructions for the other Runark board that I have. Like I said, I got two of them, so. This one has... Which game is this? This one is... I don't know if you can read that or not. This is Charlie Ninja. So this is a pretty unique board to find. Not very common to see, especially up for sale. But interesting board nonetheless. I don't even think I'm going to get through all of these boards here in one video. But just to give you an idea anyway. Running out of space to put this stuff to. And what else we got? More Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles wiring. Board here is my Outrun, or not Outrun, my mistake. This is Drift Out. This is the vertical board. As you can see down there, it's made by Visco. I only made one video of this, but I played it a ton, especially when my machine was in the vertical position. This is Contra here, as you can see. This is the one that I got from El Cheapo Uno, and a fantastic game. Really love it. It's a little Konami CPU there. I gotta try and put some of these boards back in there a little bit better. This is my second Mortal Kombat 1, I think. Nope, I lied. This is NBA Jam. And behind this one is my UMK3, which you're not gonna be able to see. And in front of that, on this side, this is my Double Dragon board, which is a beast. As you can see here, it's got the strap on the side. And yeah, let's see, the Technos Japan. But yeah, this is a monster. If you guys remember from my my other video with my Double Dragon 2 boards, I got two of those broken ones. I got a whole box load of broken arcade boards here, but these are the ones that are working. This one is one of my favorite games, one of my prized possessions, and that is... Kadash. As you can see, the tail of the camera there. Yeah, this is my Kadash board. I love this board. It's a great game. Fantastic game. I'll kind of get a look at it a little bit better. But yeah, this is about 13 minutes of me just going through different arcade boards here. Hopefully it wasn't too boring for you guys. But yeah, it's about all for me for right now. Like always, I'll put up another video here soon. So thanks for watching. Let's see what else I can do. Take this one out. This Kadash board's a pretty small board. But as you can see here, it says Kadash. I wish this thing would focus, but it's not gonna. No. But yeah, if you guys are thinking about getting into the arcade board collecting, try and get an idea here, or I'm trying to give you guys an idea as well as to how big these boards can get. They don't fit on shelves so convenient as regular like Nintendo carts and things like that, but they are quite historic pieces of you know, machinery, and they're still a lot of fun to play. So if you come across some of these things, definitely recommend picking them up. But yeah, so until the next video.